Good evening and welcome to the news tonight. Rajya Sabha just adjourned now for the day, but then an important bill passed in Lok Sabha as well today. We'll get you details of that in a bit. I'm Tracy Shilshi and here are the headlines. Lok Sabha passes the Juvenile Justice Amendment Bill, paving the way for teens in the 16 to 18 age group to be tried as adults for heinous crimes. Government assures the bill will protect the rights of minors as well. India-Bangladesh land boundary agreement ratified by both houses of parliament. Prime Minister Modi thanks Congress President Sonia Gandhi for the support. Cabinet extends the current session of Lok Sabha by three more days, hoping to push through some key bills that are still pending. The session will now continue till the 13th of May. A six-month low for the Sensex ends below the 27,000 mark. Rupee 2 records a 20-month low against the US dollar. And the United Kingdom goes to polls in what's being seen as the most unpredictable election in decades. Opinion polls have said Tories and Labour are running neck and neck. Hung Parliament on the cards. Our top story, the amended Juvenile Justice Bill was passed in Lok Sabha today. It is aimed at allowing children in the 16 to 18 years age group to be tried as adults if they commit heinous crimes. The government said it has tried to strike a fine balance to ensure that no injustice was done to innocent children. Here are the details.
Lok Sabha passed the Juvenile Justice Bill by a voice vote on Wednesday. The bill paves way for trying juveniles aged between 16 and 18 years for heinous crimes under laws for adults. During the discussion, Women and Child Development Minister Menaka Gandhi assured the House that the government has kept the UN Convention in mind to protect the rights of minors in the bill.
We have achieved a fine balance between the two aspects through the instrument of a two-stage assessment process. Further, the orders of juvenile justice boards have been made appealable at both stages. Therefore, while the inherent rights of the child will not be compromised under any circumstance in this process, the bill, when enacted, will also provide a minimum deterrence to the juveniles from ruining their future and their victims' future by committing heinous crimes. What I would like the members to appreciate is this bill is more about strengthening of child protection systems, reformation of adoption processes, and providing new mechanisms for care and protection.
At least 42 official amendments were moved by the government to the bill, which were adopted, while all the amendments moved by opposition members were negated. Earlier, opposition objected to the proposal to raise the age bar, expressing apprehensions about misuse and violation of rights of children.
Hamari jo ameeri aur garibi ki diwar hai, us bacche ki kuntha hai, ye bhi bahut zyada is baat ke liye zimmedar hai ki hum us gap ko kam nahi kar pa rahe.
It is very welcome step on, at least even though the standing committee has recommended, the government was not cared to hear the demand of the standing committee. Today morning the honorable speaker has intimated this house that clause 7 is going to be negative. It is fully welcome.
The clauses in the present bill, they clearly violate UNCRC reform and rehabilitation. Instead of strengthening functional assessment, probation and counseling for juveniles, nothing is being done. And let me point out to Honorable Minister, how many sections of IPC, 21 sections of IPC, sir, which includes 121B.
The bill states that a juvenile justice board will examine such cases to assess if the crime was committed as a child or as an adult. New offences including illegal adoption, corporal punishment in childcare institutions, use of children by terrorist groups and offences against disabled children have also been incorporated in the proposed legislation. The bill, seen as a result of the nationwide outrage over the Delhi gang rape in December 2012, also proposes to streamline adoption procedures for orphaned, abandoned and surrendered children by making mandatory registration of all institutions engaged in providing childcare. With inputs from Pranav Goswami, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Well, the Congress's Shashi Tharoor in fact claimed the NDA government will regret its decision. For more on this, we've got Madhavi Diwan, who's advocate with the Supreme Court, joining us this evening in studio. Madhavi, thanks so much for joining us. First of all, your reaction really to this bill finally being passed, you know, the government in a way succumbing to public pressure?
Well, one way of looking at it is that it's succumbing to public pressure. The other way of looking at it is that governments have to be sensitive to what civil society feels. And, you know, there are social changes which have taken place over the last several decades. And one of them is, of course, I mean, the laws cannot be divorced from, you know, what is happening in society. And today you have a you know, children are maturing faster. The age of sexual awakening is reduced. So people are, you know, sexually awakened at a younger age. You have, you know, a much greater the impact of media, of films. There's a sort of 24/7 onslaught on the young mind. Mm. So there is a lot happening, and that, and this amendment, it would seem, only is confining itself to heinous crimes, which is a very special category.
Yes.
And I don't believe that civil society generally should be so, it would not be generally bloodthirsty about, you know, on children. And therefore, I think rather than to just look at it from, you know, one angle, I think it's so important to remember that, yes, you know, young people are capable of heinous crimes, and yes, therefore the law needs to address the situation. But of course, I think it's important that there is a screening committee that safeguards the rights of children. And I think there are people who are sensitive to,
yes,
the needs of children. There are social workers, etc., on this committee who will look into that before, you know, children are just exposed to the general criminal law system.
Yes, even in fact, the minister herself, Menaka Gandhi herself, said that the government will try and, you know, strike this fine balance. But, you know, in courts, when the police is dealing with, you know, so-called accused, how difficult is it going to be on the ground to try and make sure that, you know, children don't get harassed? Because, you know, in the heat of the moment, and if a law actually, you know, if there's a law like this that comes into place, how do we see that on the ground it doesn't get misused?
But I think, therefore, what is really crucial is your screening committee.
Mm.
And that, you know, the kind of people you select over there, you know, whether they're social workers or people who are generally, you know, alive to the needs of children.
Yes.
And I think they will look at this very sensitively before just leaving children to, you know, sort of leaving them at the mercy of the general criminal law system.
Mm.
And of course, I think heinous crime is a sort of extreme category of crimes that we're talking about. And, you know, there are, you know, there's a couple of examples that I can give you. For example, there was a case of a gang rape and murder. A young girl of about 16, you know, in rural Maharashtra. And, you know, everybody, there were about five people convicted.
Mm.
They failed in the appeal. Matter went all the way to the Supreme Court. Appeals dismissed, review dismissed.
Yes.
And then one of them came up with this application saying that, you know, he was 17 years old and 10 months and a few days old on the date of the crime, and therefore he should be given the benefit of doubt, and he was given the benefit of the of doubt.
Yes.
But the point remains that, you know, there will always be an element of arbitrariness when it comes to, you know, drawing a line somewhere.
Mm.
So whether it's 17, 16, 18, you know, these are very, very tough questions.
Yes. That's absolutely right. Very quickly, this is definitely, like you pointed out, sign of changing times. The government, you know, being sensitive really to how times are changing, and actually understanding that the public too has a say in how laws need to be defined perhaps in, you know, years to come.
Yes, absolutely. And I think, yes, civil society has to have a say. And of course, I think we've had time for reflection after Nirbhaya.
Yes.
And Nirbhaya is not the only case.
Mm.
You know, 2.5 years have passed since Nirbhaya. And I believe and I hope that the government has reflected upon this.
Yes.
Consulted experts on this before they have taken this step. And I think what is, again, I'm going to emphasize this, is the screening committees are going to be very, very crucial over
All
here.
Right.
Very crucial.
All right. Madhavi Diwan, thanks so much for joining us this evening and helping us understand, you know, further as to how this will be implemented on the ground. Thank you so much. Meanwhile, staying with Parliament, it cleared the bill to ratify the land boundary agreement with Bangladesh, with the Lok Sabha passing the measure. The bill was once again passed unanimously by the lower house a day after it sailed through the upper house without a single vote against it. Prime Minister Narendra Modi thanked opposition parties for support to the bill. He also personally thanked Congress President Sonia Gandhi for backing the land swap deal. Later, Modi also spoke to Bangladesh Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina over the issue. The bill is intended to end decades of uncertainty for thousands of citizens living in the enclaves on the wrong side of their homeland's border. 15 states in India now have to clear the amendment to finally grant them citizenship.
जैसे मैंने कहा था कि राज्यसभा में एक भी पीला बटन नहीं दबा, कोई एब्सेंशन नहीं थी, एक भी लाल बटन नहीं दबा, कोई भी नो नहीं था. अगर यहाँ भी ये बिल इसी तरह से पारित हो जाए कि केवल आयज ही आयज हो, तो बांग्लादेश को नहीं, हमारे पड़ोसी देशों को भी और विश्व को भी एक बहुत बढ़िया संदेश जाएगा कि इस तरह के मसलों पर भारत में कोई राजनीतिक दलों में विमत नहीं होता, बल्कि सब एक साथ केवल राष्ट्रहित में सोचते हैं.
ये बांग्लादेश संगे शुद्ध यही चुक्ति नहीं, समस्या समाधान हो ना. বাংলাদেশ সঙ্গে বাংলাদেশের সঙ্গে ভালো হৃদয়তাপূর্ণ সম্বন্ধ গড়ে তোলার জন্য ওখানে উন্নয়ন দরকার. যদি কেউ এর উপরে বিচার করে,
লেট দ্য মেসেজ গো আউট টু দ্য হোল অফ সাউথ এশিয়া দ্যাট উই ওয়ান্ট পিস এন্ড ডেভেলপমেন্ট ফর দ্য পুয়ার এন্ড অবসকিউর হু লিভ অল অ্যাক্রস দিস গ্রেট সাবকন্টিনেন্ট.
The Union Cabinet has decided to extend session of the Lok Sabha till 13th of May. The ongoing session in the lower house was earlier scheduled to end tomorrow, but it will sit for another 3 days next week. The decision was taken due to several pending bills in Lok Sabha. The government is expected to table bills on black money, waterways and the Delhi High Court on these 3 days. Meanwhile, the future of the proposed land acquisition bill too remains uncertain. There is ongoing debate over whether it should be sent to a parliamentary standing committee.
There are many legislations which are pending, and there is a great cooperation in the House by members of Parliament. So the CCPA has decided, and a meeting chaired and held in the CCPA, has been decided to extend the House for next 3 days, beginning Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday, that is 11th, 12th and 13th.
Meanwhile, Congress Vice President Rahul Gandhi slammed the Modi government today over a stalled food park project in his constituency in Amethi. Speaking in Lok Sabha, he accused the government of vendetta politics. However, Home Minister Rajnath Singh rejected the allegation and said the government will look into the matter.
Speaker, through you, I agree.
A day after Congress President Sonia Gandhi accused the government of not fulfilling its poll promises in the last 1 year, her son Rahul Gandhi accused Prime Minister Modi of reneging on his commitments. During the 0 hour in the Lok Sabha on Thursday, Rahul questioned the government over its decision to cancel a proposed food park in his constituency, Amethi.
भाषण में उन्होंने एक अच्छी बात कही जो उस समय मुझे अच्छी लगी थी. उन्होंने कहा कि मैं यहाँ बदले की राजनीति करने नहीं आया हूँ, मैं बदलाव की राजनीति करने आया हूँ. किसानों से वायदा किया, मजदूरों से वायदा किया कि वो बदले की राजनीति नहीं करेंगे, मगर वो हुआ है. Food park ko cancel kiya gaya.
Rahul alleged that the center had scrapped the project which would have benefited farmers in 10 districts.
To maine kisanon se pucha aur unhone kaha ki Rahul ji iska karan ye hai ki jo factories banti hain wo hamare se dur hoti hain. Agar hum directly apna maal factory mein bech pate,
yes,
to jo beech mein se log paisa le jate hain bichole, unko fayda nahi hoga aur pura paisa hame milega. ये फूड पार्क के पीछे सोच थी कि इस फूड पार्क से अमेठी के किसानों की जिंदगी में बहुत बड़ा बदलाव आएगा.
yes.
उनको पैसा मिलेगा, उनको फायदा होगा, और इस फूड पार्क को आप कैंसिल मत कीजिए. धन्यवाद.
Amid sparring between the treasury and opposition benches, Home Minister Rajnath Singh assured the house that the government is not indulging in politics of vendetta.
यदि आपने कहा है तो इस पूरे मामले को मैं दिखवा लूंगा, और मैं व्यक्तिगत रूप से आपको इसकी मैं जानकारी भी दे दूंगा.
During his speech, Rahul Gandhi highlighted how he had worked to have the food park project allotted to Amethi after farmers raised the issue with him. The planned 200 crore project was expected to create thousands of jobs with food processing units for potatoes, sugarcane and other products. Bureau report, Rajya Sabha Television.
Meanwhile, falling for the third straight day, Sensex today tumbled to a six-month low. The rupee also fell to its lowest figures against the dollars in the last 20 months. A day after its biggest fall in 4 months, Sensex today shed 118 points to end below the 27,000 mark. Nifty too fell by about 40 points to close at 8,057. The fall is attributed to persistent selling by foreign investors over taxation worries and delay in passage of key reform bills. Rupee too came under some pressure. It has hit a 20-month low against the dollar today, breaching the 64 mark since September 2013. This was the fifth straight day that the rupee had a fall. And coming up ahead on the show, Germany backs the US concerns over Centre's action against foreign-funded NGOs. We'll get you details in a bit.
आजादी के बाद कैसे बदला परिवेश, कैसे बनी संसद, कैसे उठा देश।
When the world sleeps, India will awake to life and freedom. Freedom.
कौन थे वो लोग जो दे गए हमको शानदार विरासत, लोकतंत्र की मजबूत इमारत, राज्यसभा टेलीविजन।
Welcome back. You're watching the news tonight. Now, Germany joined the US today, raising concerns over the Indian government's actions against some foreign NGOs working in the country. The center cancelled licenses of nearly 9,000 NGOs last month for violation of the Foreign Contribution Regulation Act. Amid row over his remarks on the center's punitive action, US envoy Richard Verma met PMO officials and Lok Sabha Speaker Sumitra Mahajan today.
The regulatory actions that are being taken could have a chilling effect on speech and expression.
This remark by the US envoy on Wednesday night says it all about Washington's concerns over punitive action taken by the center against foreign-funded NGOs in India. Over 9,000 such NGOs have lost their licenses since last month. Several key organizations like Greenpeace and the Ford Foundation are also on the center's watch list. Richard Verma met Lok Sabha Speaker Sumitra Mahajan and PMO officials on Thursday, even as his comments on the centre imposing restrictions on international agencies drew fire from both the government and opposition parties.
अगर कुछ संस्थाएं जो कि एनजीओ के नाम पर खड़ी है और वो कानून की धज्जियां उड़ा रही हो, कानूनी व्यवस्था को बिल्कुल पालन नहीं कर रही हो, तो उनको जो है वो इस बात का अधिकार है सरकार को कि उनकी जांच पड़ताल करें, उनके बारे में जानकारी ले कि वो क्या कर रहे हैं।
यूएस एम्बेसडर ही स्पीक्स इन दिस लैंग्वेज, दिस इज फॉर गवर्नमेंट टू जस्टिफाई इट्स डिसीजन एंड गवर्नमेंट मस्ट रिस्पॉन्स ऑन दिस।
अमेरिका सरकार भारत सरकार के मामले में दखल दे रही है। अमेरिकी राजदूत के उस बयान की भी मैं निंदा करता हूँ जिसमें उन्होंने भारत के आंतरिक मामलों में झांकने का प्रयास।
एनजीओज विच आर फंडेड बाय US multinationals or companies, what work they do, it is a different thing. There are laws even in our country to regulate the operations, functions of NGOs. Government of India should explain what is the rationale behind all the actions being taken against such NGOs.
Despite the criticism, Germany stood beside what the US envoy has said. German ambassador to India echoed similar views on how a vibrant civil society is important for democratic traditions and that those who act peacefully to seek change are not anti-government.
We share the view. NGOs have a very important role in our open democratic societies. At the same time, transparency is a necessity in all the activities, in private activities, in governmental activities, also for the NGOs.
Earlier, the center had clarified that the decision to crack down on some of the NGOs was taken as they failed to comply with the regulation of filing annual returns. Though the opposition backed the government's decision for more transparency in the working of the foreign-funded NGOs, they cautioned against victimization of those not in line with the government's policies. With inputs from Akhilesh Suman, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha Television.
And that's all we have for you on the news tonight. Thanks so much for joining us.